Welcome to the spoken tutorial on Basics of Bezier Tool using Inkscape. In this tutorial, we will learn to draw straight lines and closed shapes, draw curved lines, add, edit and delete nodes. To record this tutorial, I am using Ubuntu Linux 12.04 OS, Inkscape version 0.48.4. I will be recording this tutorial in maximum resolution mode. This is to accommodate all the tools that will be demonstrated. Let us open Inkscape. First, let us draw a straight line using Bezier tool. The Bezier tool is right below the pencil tool. Let's click on it. Observe the four options in the tool controls bar at the top left. There are four modes of drawing Bezier curve. By default, the Create Regular Bezier Path option is enabled. Click once on the canvas and move the cursor to the other end. Click once again. Notice that the line drawn is highlighted in green color. Now, right click to complete the line. The two end points of the line are called nodes. We will learn more about them a little later. Next, let us draw a triangle. First, draw a slanted line. Click once and draw another line at an angle. Now click once more to draw a third line and join it with a starting node to complete the triangle. Next, we will draw a curved line using Bezier tool. Click on the canvas to draw a straight line. Click again, hold and drag to form a curve. Right click to complete the curve. In a similar way, draw some more curve shapes on the canvas. Remember these steps. Click and draw a straight line. Click again. Hold and drag to form a curve. Then right click to complete the curve. Press Ctrl plus A and clear the canvas before proceeding further. Next, let us learn how to draw a closed curved path. First, draw a curved line on the canvas. When we release the mouse and move the cursor away from the end node of the curved line, we see a curved path in red color. If you click once and move the cursor, we see a straight path in red color. To make it as a curve, click and drag. Again at the end node, the line curves as we move. Again click once, we see a straight path in red color. To make the straight line curved, click and drag. Again at the end node, the line curves as we move. Move the cursor and go back to the starting node and close the path. Go to Tool Controls bar. Click on the second icon of the mode. This helps to create spiral paths and irregular shapes. Draw some irregular curves and close the path. Observe that it transforms into the closest spiral shape. Let me clear the canvas now. The third icon creates only straight lines. Click on it and draw lines on the canvas. Note, we cannot draw curved lines in this mode. We can draw triangles or polygons which have straight sides. Click on the last icon and draw on the canvas. In this mode, we can draw only parallel and perpendicular lines, that is either vertical or horizontal lines. So, we can draw squares or rectangles in this mode. Let me delete all the shapes drawn. Shape option helps to draw lines or curves in a particular shape. Click on the drop-down button. There are five options here. None, triangle in, triangle out, ellipse, from clipboard. The first option, that is none, does not give any effect. So, we will move on to triangle in. Click on it and draw a line on the canvas. The line is transformed to a triangle shape inwards. Next, click on triangle out and draw a line on the canvas. Now, a triangle shape is formed outwards. Click on the ellipse and draw a line. Observe that the line is an ellipse shape. We will learn about the last option, that is from clipboard, in later tutorial. Now, let us learn how to add, edit and delete nodes. This can be done using the Node tool. Delete the lines on the canvas. Go to Tool Controls Bar, change the mode to Regular Path and Shape to None. Come back to the canvas and draw a rough human palm. Now, click on the Node tool. Notice all the nodes in this figure are visible. Turn your attention to the Tool Controls Bar. The first 6 icons here helps to add and delete nodes and paths. Refer to the tooltip to understand better. Click on any segment. Notice both the nodes turn blue. Then, click on the Add Node option. Observe that a new node has been added exactly in between the nodes of the selected segment. Now, select the smaller segment and repeat the above steps. You will see that a new node is added at the midpoint of the smaller segment. Now, select the newly added node. Click on the Delete Node option. The node is now deleted. Click on any one of the nodes on the palm. To make the bezier handle visible, click on the last but one icon on the Tool Controls Bar. Now the bezier handles for the selected segment is visible. If not, then just click on the segment and without releasing the mouse, move it a little. The segment will curve and the bezier handles will be visible now. Click on the handles to resize and rotate the selected node. In a similar way, modify the other nodes too. The next icon helps to join nodes. Observe, there is an extra node in the index finger. Select the extra middle node and the top node using the Shift key. Now, click on Join Node icon. Observe that the nodes are now joined together. The next icon helps to break path at selected nodes. Let me now break the connection between the thumb and the index finger. So, select the joining node in between and click on Break Path icon. And select the node, then select it again and move it a little. You will notice that the path is broken and the nodes are separated into two distinct nodes. To join them, select the same two nodes and click on the Join Selected End Nodes icon on the Tool Controls Bar. Notice a new path is created between these two nodes. Click on the next icon, that is Delete Segment icon, to remove the path or segment. Now, the path is removed. Press Ctrl plus Z to undo this action. Let me keep this hand aside. Click on the Node tool once again. Let us learn how to use next 4 icons on the Tool Controls Bar. These icons helps to edit the selected nodes. Using the Bezier tool, draw an inverted U-shape. Click on the Node tool. Observe, there are 3 nodes. Select the top node and click on Make Selected Nodes Corner icon on the Tool Controls Bar. This makes it as a corner node. Click on the Bezier handles and move them up and down to see the change. Click on the next icon to make the node smooth. Observe the change in the shape. Click on the next icon, which makes the node symmetric. Click on the next icon, which makes the node auto-smooth. The next 2 icons works only on segments. So, select the left segment of the U-shape and click on the first icon. As the tooltip says, the segment is now made into a straight line. Click on the Bezier handle and try to move. You will see that we cannot make it curved. Click on the next icon to make it a curved line again. Now move the bezier handles and now we can make it into a curve shape. Click on the next icon to convert selected object to path. Click on the next icon to convert the stroke to path. Click and drag the nodes to make the strokes visible. The next two icons helps to move the selected nodes in X and Y directions respectively. Click on the up and down arrows and observe the change. The next two icons works only if the path has clipping and marking effects. You can explore these options on your own. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we learned to draw straight lines and close the shapes, draw curved lines, add, edit and delete nodes. Here is an assignment for you. Draw a flower with 5 petals, 1 stem and 2 leaves using Bezier tool. Color the petals with pink color. Color the stem and leaves with green color. Your completed assignment should look like this. The video available at the following link summarizes the Spoken Tutorial project. Please watch it. The Spoken Tutorial project team conducts workshops and gives certificates for those who pass an online test. For more details, please write to us. Spoken Tutorial project is supported by the NMEICT-MHRD Government of India. More information on this mission is available at this link. We have come to the end of this tutorial. This is Aarti and Saurabh from IIT Bombay signing off. Thanks for joining.